Hey folks, what's up? Ashish here for WPX Box, and in this post we're going to review Micromax first Windows Phone, the canvas went W121. Again, a funny nomenclature, but that's a device you're looking at. So I've been testing this device since 1 week, and I've gone through all ups and downs because I'm a traditionally Lumia user, and I know what I was missing and what I really liked about the device at this particular price point. So let's begin with the review. Display and screen. So similar to the Zolo's Windows Phone, Micromax also delivers a pretty good quality of the display. So you can see the resolution of 720p here, not much of color differences. That's a good quality. I mean, it's a 5-inch phone, right? So when you see a lot of text and such a huge display, you really like it from every perspective, be it watching video or be it playing a game or be it just using the phone. It's amazing. Now that said, one should really know the sunlight readability of this. So how good was it at when it went to sunlight? Exceptionally good, because when I changed my display settings from automatic to light mode or even medium, or when I go from to a high setting, I can actually read text in sunlight. I mean, not direct sunlight, but you expect it to work during a broad daylight when you have a lot of light, unexpected and normal. Surprisingly, the automatic mode wasn't working that well. I had to move to medium or light. Now let's move to the swipe experience. Now what happens when you have to swipe a lot and you don't really get that smooth feeling which you should actually get in the device? So you know, you should get a smooth feeling when you are actually swiping and swiping and swiping. Now disappointingly, this doesn't happen with this canvas device. For some reason, it had a lot more resistance than compared to any other phone which I have used in the same range. While it's Zolo, it was like pretty smooth because I just used it like a week back. I had trouble here. Now the best use case was I gave it to my son to play Asphalt 8 Heat, and when selecting the modes, he had to press next and it wasn't working for him that really smooth. Now reason is, kids don't press that lot hard. They play it like, they press it like smoothly one by one, and that didn't happen. So that is one problem. Even I personally feel like when tweeting or posting on Twitter, Facebook, when I hit the press button, I really need to hit twice. Now that's not happening in one application, that's happening in multiple applications, and it's like a general thing. Swiping is not really smooth. Build and design. So how does it feel in your hand? Now it's really a big phone. It's a 5-inch phone. The Zolo phone can fit into this phone. So you know, if you have really a small hand, you shouldn't be really going for this. But if you have a big hand, this device is like awesome, because you have a 720p display, you're gonna see more. When you hold it, you actually feel like it's a strong phone in your hand. It's that kind of build quality. So if I talk about the rear case now, the rear case is really premium because it's leather case. It's thin, but it's all level mounted, and you have cuts for everything, and it looks really, really good. Interesting to note that the camera module actually protrudes a little bit out here. Which is not really annoying, there's nothing wrong with it, but it does actually protrude out. And you have a Micromax label also right here, the logo here. And you do have cut for speakers as well. So overall, the rear case is really premium, and anybody who is looking at it cannot really miss this. Sides. You have a button here, which is the power button, there's no camera button. Then on the reverse, you do have a volume knocker, and that's about it. The rear is all like, you know, it's like plastic or plastic stuff, which is pretty strong and gives a premium feeling again. Front. Now this is where Micromax has disappointed us. It doesn't feel premium. It's almost the reverse of the rear. I mean, the overall looks like a very regular phone. Anybody is having a Micromax phone or even a Samsung phone probably, it looks the same. And the worst part is there are backlit buttons, capacitive buttons here, which just lit up half, not even full, it's half. It looks cheap, and they are not proportionate to the size of the actual phone. It should have been bigger. I don't know why Micromax actually made compromises here, but it really doesn't look good from this side. Camera, video and a picture quality. So it does have a 8 megapixel of rear camera and 2 megapixel of front camera. So now the rear camera, I've done a separate review, you should actually go and read it. It's by one of my friends who is pretty amazing on photography, Kuntal Gupta, and you should actually go and read it. Now, if I have to say it in one line, the pictures are very, very good when you do it in daylight, The details picked up are very nice, even the color production is pretty good. Now, front camera is good, it's only 2 megapixels, so it's overall good at this price point to have a front camera where you can go for Skype and all video calls. Application performance. Now, this phone has 1.2 GHz of Snapdragon 200 processor with 1 GB of RAM, 8 GB of internal storage, Adreno 302. So overall, there is no lags in the OS when you're using the phone. I've used Windows Phone for a very long time. It even works on a 512 MB RAM. So applications will not be a problem. Any new application which shows up will work because it has 1 GB of RAM. A couple of you actually asked me about multitasking. So you can actually run around like 8 applications simultaneously and your phone will never get slow. You can even close down by swiping them down or just tapping on the cross and it just works fine. With the amount of RAM and the processor, it's not a problem at all, really. Gaming performance. So I picked up Asphalt 8 Airborne to test on that. Surprisingly, there is no lag. And even though Solo had a problem at FPS, there's no problem at FPS. The display looks really good. They are very sharp. Even with speakers, they sound really, really good. I've done a gaming review also, if you want to take a look on how it actually delivers. And overall, it's pretty good. The only drawback of the phone is it heats up a lot right here heavily. I mean, like after playing the game, if you try to make a call, you're actually going to feel the heat right here. And this Micromax logo, which is like metal here, and the camera ring over here, they both get heated big time. So from that perspective, it's really, really no if you play a game, play a lot of games. I mean, I didn't expect this kind of heat from a phone like this. Battery performance. So can this phone last actually a day with you? The answer is yes. I have used like calls, SMS, then have 4 email accounts, Facebook, Messenger, WhatsApp. Everything was there and I used it in a combination of Wi-Fi and 3G and 3G alone. So overall, on an average, it's going to last for like 14 to 16 hours for sure. Which means by the time you are home or you are at your rest place, you can hook it up to a charger. It can even survive the overnight if you turn on the battery mode. So what my experience was, if you charge up your phone for 2 cycles at least, like that's like 100 to 0% twice, your phone will start performing better on the battery side. So on day 3, when I had like gaming, music, and you know, everything, whatever I could do, and it still lasted for 15 hours. And if I do less, it can go for like 18 hours or so, or even more. Storage. Now the phone comes with 8 GB of storage, and it had like 5.3 GB remaining after the first setup. That ran up really, really fast because I had like games and music and everything transferred back. So I had like only 2 or 1.5 GB only. So which means it is enough for you to get started. You really don't need to buy a SD card and put it right away. But if you're actually planning to have more and more games and more music, I'll suggest to buy a class in SD card, 32 GB, which should help you a lot. Now a couple of you asked if this phone has OTG support. The answer is no, primarily because it's not available in on any of the Windows phone because the OS doesn't support it. Audio quality. Now let's break it into 3 parts. The one is the in-call audio quality, which you get during calls. A couple of you asked me how was it. It was actually really good and there is no network issues as well. I'm on 3G and it works for me everywhere around and the speakers are pretty loud. Second, how was the music quality when I used it with on speakers, like the phone speakers, which is right here. So it's pretty loud actually. And since it has curved display, even if you put it on a table, it doesn't create a problem. Now, there is no equalizer, there is no Dolby support, there is no audio settings in Windows Phone for Canvas, Win, and even for Zolo. So you have to deal with it. But I can tell you that the quality isn't a problem on earphones. Now, that really depends on what kind of earphones you pick up. But on an average, I've tried with a couple of earphones and it works really great. There's no problem on that either. Sensors. Now, it has all the sensors like the accelerometer and the brightness control and everything is available. But there's no compass. So one of you asked me if there is a compass available. So sorry, there's no compass available, which means you cannot use any of those apps. Lastly, there are a couple of things I always say about Windows Phone 8.1 on any phone. So you can move your apps to SD card, you have SD card support, you do have notification center, most of the apps are available on the Windows Phone segment. However, you cannot have any of the Lumia apps on there, but you do have Here Maps, because Here Maps is like now a separate division. So you have Here Maps. So if you are missing the Google Maps, you have Here Maps, but you have Gmaps Pro available if you want to use Google Maps. You have Here Drive as well, but you actually need to pay $40 to get it on any other phone on a non-Lumia phones. Conclusion. So is this phone recommendable? It's absolutely recommendable. The only problem is, the two problems actually. One is the screen is not really up to the mark when you swipe across or tap or press anything. And second, there's a lot of heating issue with the game. Now, both of these are not a problem in any of the other Nokia phones which I've seen, or even on the Zolo phone. So that's kind of drawback. But other than that, it has strong build quality. Oh, display is really good, 720p you get. Camera is pretty decent for daylight photography. You have 8GB of internal storage, faster process, good battery life. So from other perspective, it's pretty good. The only part which bothers me are the two parts which I just told you. So thanks for watching the videos, guys. And if you have any questions, please let me know. I have this phone with me for a pretty long time because I'm going to do comparison, which is like the next one. Zolo versus the Win, and even 630 versus the Canvas Win and the Zolo are all coming up in the series one by one. So if you have any questions, please let me know so I can put it in the comparison. Please share this video with your friends who are looking to buy the Canvas Win. And if you have any personal questions, you can ping me at ashish@wpxbox.com. I'll be happy to answer you. So thanks for watching.